Hello everyone. I'm Selma Teacher 7, also known as Mr. Berry by my students. The other day I showed the basic steps in creating an airplane out of an aluminum soda can. You can make all kinds of airplanes such as this SPD or other planes too. Now, today I'm going to be making an A-36 Apache. There are some things that you need for this. You need some paper to draw your plane. You'll need scissors, pencils, Sharpie pens, ruler helps, and of course some aluminum cans. When you're finding and selecting your cans, make sure it's not crumpled like this one. If it is, it's only good for your recycling heat. So, let's go ahead and get started. First of all, what you want to do is select which kind of airplane that you want to do. In this case, I already chose the Apache A-36. Now, after I chose my airplane, I drew it out, and I wanted the fuselage to be about 9 centimeters. So I use my ruler and I have about 9 centimeters on that fuselage. I went into and did some research, and according to the measurements, if I have a fuselage that's 9 centimeters, my wingspan is 10 centimeters. Therefore, each wing is going to be 5 centimeters. And for the particular type of airplane that you do, you'd be able to do those measurements as well and figure out exactly the size for each component. Now, after you've drawn out your airplane, the next step is to take the scissors and cut out what you've created, and then also make sheets out of the aluminum can. Alrighty, here I've cut out the fuselage out of the paper for my Apache. Some history about the Apache. The Apache was actually a variant of the P-51 Mustang, but the Apache was made as a dive bomber. They didn't have the Merlin engine. They had the less powerful engine. And not very many of them were made. After a time, they just made the P-51 Mustangs, and they stopped production of the A-36 Apaches. Now, as you see here, now I'm cutting out the wings. When you're designing this, you have to remember that you're going to have folds. Your wing will attach like this on the fuselage. So when you're designing it, you have to design some areas with some overlap, as I'm doing here. The same is true for your tail section. After you've cut out the fuselage and the wings section, and also the part of the tail section that we'll be needing to use as a template on our aluminum sheet, we need to fabricate our aluminum sheet. And we do this simply by taking the can and cutting an aluminum sheet out of it. I can take a knife here. Part of the way there. Take my nice sturdy scissors and cut around, as you see me doing here. Make sure that you have washed and dried the inside of your cans first. Okay, we have one aluminum sheet so far. In order to make this airplane, we'll need two of these. So, cut one more can in the same fashion. Alrighty. Now, after you've made your two sheets, now you'll need to go in and flatten those sheets out. I do that by taking one and folding it in on itself here, like this. And then there's one sheet. I'll do the same thing with the second. After making your two sheets, next thing that you want to do is take the template that you've created. Take the fuselage first. Lay it on your aluminum sheet, and then you'll trace this out. Now you're going to be forming a pattern with this so that you want both sides, so that you'll be using the same one flipped over. Now I finished drawing in my template onto my sheet. The reason why I chose the center part was because it was free from the dents and creases that I had around the edges. Now what's left to do is to cut this out with some scissors. You cut one of these out and you leave enough space for the second one. Cut one out perfectly, and then you will fold the aluminum, and then from that fold there, you'll be able to cut the other side, so it's perfect match on both sides. I've cut out one, and I left excess material around the second one. I'm now going to take the fuselage and bend it in so that they overlap and they sit on top. So now I have something that looks like this. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to glue using my amazing E6000 glue. This is for metal and aluminum. I'm going to glue these two sides together, and once I have a good bond between them, then I'll take my scissors and I'll cut out the excess. There. I've applied a very thin coat of this glue on one side of this of the inside of this fuselage. You want to be very careful with this glue. Don't get it on your fingers or on other things, because as soon as you get glue on the aluminum surface, it's difficult to wash away. Not impossible, but just difficult. Now, I'll go in and fold the two sides together. And it won't take very long before this sets and makes a very good bond with the aluminum surface. Now, after the glue has set, the two halves of the fuselage look like this. Now it's time to cut off that extra piece in the back. And you simply follow the one that you've already cut out as a pattern. All the way around, and you'll have the fuselage ready. There we go. There's the main fuselage. You can kind of see it taking shape already for the Apache. That's it right there. You have both sides of it. Our next job will be to go in, trace our wings onto the other aluminum sheet, and then cut them out, and we'll be gluing those together because we'll need four of these wings for the entire assembly here. Fit on something like that. I've traced the template for one of my wings onto the aluminum. And now the job that's remaining is just to cut this out for this one wing. You can see how when I traced it out, I left a line there to know that that's where I have to fold these two together. And I'll do the same trick as I did with the fuselage. I'm going to leave excess on the wing, fold these two together, and then glue it and cut off the excess. And so here I'm going to be folding it down the center. Here's one of the wings. I'm now going to apply a small amount of this glue onto the wing and then cut off the excess. Okay, now I have my two wings. I'm now ready to cut the excess off. And after I've cut the excess off, I'll be able see, there's one of the wings there. I'll now line it up to my template and know where to mark off the bend so I can begin the fold that connects this to the main fuselage. I'll do the same thing to my other wing. Okay, here's what we have so far. We have the two wings, and we have the fuselage. Now what I've done is I took my template and I had drawn in there where the wing fits on the fuselage. So then I took one of the wings and I put a fold into it so that it would be able to go in and sit in the perfect place there in the fuselage. There we go. It sits right into it. Now I'm going to apply some glue. Basically, I don't even need glue. Look, it sits already. I'm going to apply some glue and make that stick there as a permanent feature. I'm going to do the same thing to the other wing. What I have done so far is I've attached, I cut and I attached to both wings. And that's what we have here. I'm now going to go in and position the wings, be the right shape that I want them to be. And then I'm also going to go in and work. I've attached the tail section as well, cut that out, attached it. And that's what we see here. So there you go. Those are the steps in making an Apache or any type of an airplane out of a aluminum can. That's what the end product will look like there. And notice the folds in the wings there to attach it to the main fuselage, and you also have folds in the tail section to keep it together. And then I've also drawn these together. Alrighty. Well, thank you. Hope you great success in when you're making your little airplanes.